Hey, what's up, folks? This is Jesse with Keeping It Real Finance, the channel that always has your back and tells it like it is. Well, today's video is basically a follow-up to yesterday's video on Binance in the news, FUD, or something more. Well, news happens fast in the crypto space, and Binance announced just today that they will no longer be offering tokenized stocks. So that was kind of the premise of yesterday's video. I talked all about derivatives, that's exactly what this is, and that's why all these watchdogs have been on Binance. So we're gonna be getting into that in today's video. It should be pretty interesting. This is gonna be a short one, but straight to the point. So hopefully you'll get all the info you need by the end of it. Feel free to leave me comments on what you think about this, what's going on in the crypto space. I find it very interesting. And so that being said, if you enjoy today's video, make sure to hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. And if you click the bell, you'll be made aware whenever I post time-sensitive content just like this. And now let's get it going. So I want to kick this video off by first saying that if you go to Binance's website, you will get the following notice. So it says, effective immediately, new stock tokens are unavailable for purchase on Binance.com, and Binance.com will no longer support any stock tokens after the 14th of October, 2021. Now, if you then click the Learn More button, you get the following. So this says that they're officially announcing that stock tokens are going kaput. Users who hold stock tokens effectively have 90 days to sell. Now it does say that there is an option for users who are located in the European Economic Area and Switzerland, that those users may be holding stock tokens that they can transition their balances to CM Equity AG once a new portal is created 2 to 4 weeks before the deadline to transition the assets. So they have a further disclaimer that you need to agree to the new terms of service, effectively removing stock tokens. And what's really interesting is the last sentence that says, all stock tokens listed on Binance are products issued and sold by CM Equity AG Germany. Interesting, okay? So because I've never heard of CM Equity Germany, I decided to look them up, go to their website, where I found the following. So CM Equity and Digital Assets AG are offering a regulatory compliant, API-driven, scalable infrastructure framework that creates a new dimension and limitless user experience in the financial markets. Now, with the introduction of tokenized shares, the firms truly created the capital market 4.0. Now, this is hilarious because it means that Binance was simply using APIs that they bought on the sales pitch from CM Equity that they were offering in stock tokens was regulatory compliant, which in fact it was not, all right? Now, even more, I then clicked the full news and found the following, so it gets better. So we have publications on April 12th regarding tokenizing shares. Then we conveniently have photos of Sam Bankman-Fried and CZ endorsing CM Equity. Hilarious. So per Sam, Digital Assets AG are an integral part of the tokenized stock system. They're years ahead of similar companies trying to accomplish the same thing. Everyone talks about tokenizing stocks. The team from Digital Assets AG actually does it. Great. Anyone want to bet if FTX is the next target of regulators? I'll put money on that one. Then we have CZ saying, Binance serves many users around the world, and we're very pleased to be able to help them participate in the equity market. Stock tokens demonstrate how we can democratize value transfer more seamlessly, reduce friction and cost to accessibility without compromising on compliance or security. Through connecting traditional and crypto markets, we are building another technological bridge for a more inclusive financial future. So looking at the quote now is very telling, okay? So it says CZ bought what CM Equity was selling, that it was fully compliant. Crazy. So basically, if you're still following, CM Equity, through a great sales pitch, sold tokenized stock APIs to Binance FTX and others under the premise that they were then fully compliant. The unfortunate reality is that these tokenized stock derivatives are basically securities, okay? So in order to offer tokenized stocks, you need to be fully compliant with securities and exchange laws within any country you're opening up shop. So what we're left with here is basically a great sales pitch that effectively blew up on Binance and will more than likely blow up on FTX next. So heads up, Tom Brady, that's coming. So I haven't mentioned yet that we also had Binance warned by Hong Kong today and Italy yesterday after I posted the video for the exact same thing, okay? Now, the interesting part in all of this is that if CZ really wants to do what he was quoted, quote, building a bridge between basically crypto and traditional markets, he sure is throwing in the towel pretty quickly, okay? I got to admit that. So what I'm getting at is why not just pause the tokenized stocks while they work with the vendor, this is CM Equity, to become regulatory compliant? You would think that CM Equity would have a role in this somehow in the places they set this up, because again, that's part of their sales pitch, right? But really, maybe what they're saying is they're regulatorily compliant, but not necessarily whoever they sell their APIs to, all right? So another head scratcher here, I think, is how we got here in the first place, right? So I mentioned in yesterday's video that Binance made $662 billion, with a B, dollars in June alone. So guessing at their yearly revenue, it has to be somewhere around the ballpark of $5 to $6 trillion. That is absolutely insane, especially for a company that is 4 years old. $5 to $6 trillion. Now, how on earth does a company that operates worldwide and makes that much money not have an entire regulatory compliance department, corporate officer, teams for each country, making sure that they are compliant at all times with regulation, wherever they're doing business, right? So the only thought that I can come to is that because they've only been a company for 4 years, this is basically a public example of growing pain and something that they need to work out, right? Now, ultimately, I still kind of like the idea of tokenized stocks, I'll be honest, because it's basically bringing a derivative of a real company from one corner of the globe to another. I think that's kind of a neat idea. Now, the reality though, is that if you're going to be an exchange that offers tokenized stocks, you are no different than an exchange that offers stocks, okay? That's the crux of all of this. Therefore, you have to play by the same rules. So the crypto world keeps turning. Binance and all this will survive. They're gonna be just fine. $662 billion a month, I think they'll make it. And if you own any tokenized stocks, this is the one time where you probably wanna get your money back, all right? I don't know how much value these things are going to hold, especially once all the crypto exchanges start shutting this down. But the interesting part here that I am wondering is maybe an FTX, for example, they're US-based, maybe they will try and become regulatory compliant, just as if they were another exchange, you know, offering stocks you could buy, right? So the bottom line here is, you know, I've seen this a lot in the corporate world. Oftentimes vendors come in with great sales pitches. They sell you on this great service. They tell you how amazing it is. They tell you all the great things here. If you buy it up, eventually it ends up not being exactly what they sold you. And that's exactly what this is. So CM Equity sold something that they're saying they're regulatory compliant. I almost feel a term of detrimental reliance here, because that's what Binance did, clearly. Now, obviously, they should be, you know, covering their own, doing a little CYA on their end to make sure that that indeed is true. But FTX did it, and I'm pretty sure there's one or two other exchanges that are also doing this. So, yeah, it's kind of a head scratcher. So the bottom line here is that Binance is turning off tokenized stock listings. You will no longer be able to do that, period, until the foreseeable future. Again, I see CZ as he's the guy making shovels on the gold rush. You said you wanted a slightly different shovel. Well, guess what? He made you one. Was it regulatory compliant? No. So, bottom line here, Binance will recover, the world goes on, and that's that. So that's it for today's video. Hopefully you learned something here. If you got comments, by all means, leave them. I'd love to hear them. For those who don't know, I am also on Twitter at KIR Finance, where you can find me tweeting and retweeting on a regular basis. Check me out there. And for a friendly reminder, this is Jesse with Keeping It Real Finance channel. I always has your back, tells it like it is. If you enjoyed the video today, don't forget to like it, and I will see you next time. Later.